Okay, hello again. Since my last video, I got some questions how to handle this kind of old Finnish colored axe. And I will now show it too. So this is Billnes 1123. So it's a modern version of this older 12.3. And I have prepared this wedge ready, so we are now placing only one wedge, and I have estimated the size of the wedge so that it will cover around 1/3 at least of the axe eye. And now this wedge is quite fast growing pine, so it should be quite soft. And I have here the actual handle. It's been boiled in hot water, and I've been asked why this is so undone, and the reason is that I can now hit to the end of this handle without breaking it. And another reason is that if this is, the result is a bit bended to the side or another, I can adjust the shape of the handle accordingly. And before I have then rounded the shapes here with the file so that they are not sharp. And if we look at closely, so these old axes are typically asymmetrical. So it's more like a rule than exceptions. And here we have already these corners pretty nicely rounded. And let's now assemble the axe. Here I have mark where we can see how deep this axe head went when it was dry. And as you can see, it goes like maybe 7 millimeters deep. So we are compressing the wood here. And now I will split the head. I have here markings. And again, I will make this kind of a chambers here to ease up the start for the wedge. And the reason why this part is so long is that it ease up the start for the wedge. Otherwise it has to start from the tightest point of the wood, and there's a risk of snapping. And I have here mark so that I will know not to go too deep, as this penetrated a bit more once it was now softer. So I will place a new mark not to go too deep. So you don't have to go too deep. You can have some room for retightening in case you are storing this indoors and it dries really heavily. So if it starts to move, you can then hit like this and then tap the wedge a bit deeper. But with this technique you can be sure that it doesn't fly off even if it would dry out. Now the wedge is in, so we start to hit on the wedge. Okay, it's now in, as you can see from the mark. And I will then saw the extra off. And then I will shape this with the knife. And as you can see, the mushroom is really great. It didn't went totally symmetrical inside, but you can be for sure that it doesn't fly off accidentally. So in case this dries really much, so you can hit it against something, and then for example with large nail hit this a bit deeper, so then it fits again. And this is really worn out axe head, so probably I will leave this axe to some unlocked cabin in wilderness just for case.
But to prevent the drying, I also added salt in the water because it then absorbs the moist. And you can also put boiled linseed oil into the handle.